Welcome to an example of determining a positive and negative coterminal angle to a given angle in radians rather than degrees. Let's go ahead and sketch this angle in standard position. Here's the initial side. If you're still not comfortable with radians, you could convert this to degrees, but hopefully by now you recognize this as 60 degrees. So pi over 3 radians is approximately here. And if we want another coterminal angle, meaning an angle that has the same terminal side, we just need to add or subtract multiples of 2 pi radians to the given angle in radians. So if we're going to be adding or subtracting multiples of 2 pi to pi over 3, let's go ahead and write 2 pi over 1 with a denominator of 3 so we can easily add it to pi over 3 radians. So we'd have to multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. So 2 pi radians is equal to 6 pi over 3 radians. So to determine another positive coterminal angle to pi over 3 radians, we'll just take pi over 3 radians and add 2 pi, or in this case, 6 pi over 3 radians. Well, pi over 3 is the same as 1 pi over 3, so another positive coterminal angle would be 7 pi over 3 radians. And that would be this angle here. And to determine a negative coterminal angle, what we'll do is subtract 2 pi radians, or 6 pi over 3 radians. So we'll have pi over 3, or 1 pi over 3, minus 6 pi over 3 radians. And this will equal negative 5 pi over 3 radians. And this would be the coterminal angle that rotates clockwise here. So in general, to determine a coterminal angle to an angle in radians, we would take the given angle theta and add multiples of 2 pi times k, where k is some integer. So if k is positive, we would add multiples of 2 pi, and if k was negative, it would be the same as subtracting multiples of 2 pi radians. Let's take a look at one more example. Again, the angle is given in radians, but this time it's a negative angle. So the given angle will rotate clockwise 4 pi over 5 radians. And if you have a hard time figuring out what angle this would, we know that half of a revolution clockwise would be negative pi radians. So we'll rotate 4/5 of half a revolution clockwise. So maybe somewhere in here. This would be our given angle. And again, because we have to add or subtract multiples of 2 pi radians, let's go ahead and convert 2 pi over 1 to a denominator of 5, so multiply both the numerator and denominator by 5, 2 pi radians is the same as 10 pi over 5 radians. So from here we can take our given angle, negative 4 pi over 5, and add 10 pi over 5 radians. That'll give us positive 6 pi over 5 radians, and that would be this angle here. Now to find another negative coterminal angle, we'll go ahead and subtract 10 pi over 5 radians. And that would be negative 14 pi over 5 radians. And for this angle, we'd rotate clockwise one complete revolution and then back to the same terminal side.